Friday tradition right here in the Mahoning Valley would have to be pierogi. And one of the biggest suppliers of pierogi in the valley is St. Stan's Church, right here on Williamson Avenue, near South Avenue in Youngstown. Dorothy Mazansky is letting us into the kitchens back here at St. Stan's to see this operation. And what an operation you have.
Yeah, it's big. It is, because we start on Tuesday and we don't get done till Friday at 1 o'clock. So it is big. It's a lot of time.
It takes a week and a lot of people to make the pierogi that you make. So Dorothy, what kind of pierogi do you sell here at the church?
We sell potato, sauerkraut, and cottage cheese. The potato has cheese in them. And the sauerkraut, there's not a lot of filling in it, and it's sour. So if you really like sauerkraut, you want ours.
And everything here is from scratch. This is peeled and boiled and mashed potatoes. We are talking, you know, fresh kraut, fresh cottage cheese. Everything is done from scratch, including the dough?
Yes, yes. The potatoes are peeled. We do anywhere from 350 pounds to 550 pounds of potatoes a week.
Well, I think it's really great. We're here on an evening, on a Wednesday evening, and what's so nice is that you're accommodating your volunteer schedules, so if they want to help out here at the church and work at night, you're making sure that you're not wasting their talents.
Right. Well, a lot of people work during the day, so they can't come down on Thursday mornings. And so we do them on Wednesday night, and we do get a nice crowd, sometimes 30, a little more. And they just work. It's fun. You'll have to wait and see.
Chris Johnson is making the dough, and that's quite a job you have.
And it's not the green stuff either.
The white stuff. That was a good one.
It's the stuff that sticks.
Yeah, the green stuff ain't sticking to me either. All right, so what are the ingredients for this special pierogi dough?
It's flour, eggs, salt, oil, and water.
So now we've already got the flour and egg in there.
And the salt. We put salt in.
Okay.
Everything's in there except the water yet.
All right. So what are we looking for in consistency?
Just so that it'll be firm enough for them to roll out there.
And it'll pull away from the sides?
Yeah.
Jimmy Mazansky's on sheeter duty. So how many times do you have to run it through this for the proper thickness?
Depends, about 3 or 4 times. You want the proper thickness, so depends on each one.
And you just have a trained eye for this by this time, huh?
Yeah, my mom taught me well, so, you know, when she's here, she always makes things, everything's perfect.
How long have you been volunteering down here at St. Stan's?
2 years. 2 years, and I'm not a member either of the church. I come because of my sister.
Look, we've hit the mother load. The cottage cheese balls for stuffing the cottage cheese pierogi. My mom's favorite. Gonna have to bring her home a dozen. Pat Conway here is the original pierogi crew right here at St. Stan's for the last 30 years.
About 30.
And you've always been a pincher.
Yeah, it's what I do best.
And what is the art? The perfect look at
pinching it so they don't come apart in the boiling water.
We got Double D in the kitchen on cooking duty. Dawn and Diane. Dawn, how long have you been volunteering down here at St. Stan's?
A little over a year since they started the Wednesday night crowd.
And how did you get on cooking duty?
They pushed me here and I said okay.
And what is the art of making sure these pierogi are perfectly boiled?
You have to let them rise in the boiling water and then let them cook for an additional minute or so. You can kind of see in the dough if it's done or not.
We joke about finding this therapeutic. I mean, after answering phone calls and crunching numbers and meeting deadlines all day, I mean, it's fun just to come down here and cook and see the results of your hard work at the end of the night.
As a fundraiser for the church, how important are the pierogi sales?
It's very important because of our parishioners, they're dwindling. A lot of people are out in the suburbs now. So it actually helps a lot. If we didn't have the pierogi program, we probably would have a very hard time making our bills. So it's very important, very important. And we have to keep it going.
And it's all volunteers?
All volunteers. Nobody gets paid a dime. And everybody pays for their pierogies. If you want pierogies, you pay for them. Volunteer or not. So.
So there is no such thing as a free lunch. So what's the procedure for ordering if people want to pick up some pierogi?
Okay, we start taking orders at 8 o'clock on Thursday, probably until 11, 12 o'clock. And then we continue taking orders Friday morning, starting at 8 o'clock, until the availability is gone. So if they're big orders, I'd like a week or two in advance. I'm talking 10 dozen or more.
And on Fridays from 11 to 1, you also serve hot lunches right here at the Hall at St. Stan's.
Yeah, we sell all three kinds, and they're hot. You come down. And we've had as many as 157 people eat lunch with us on Fridays.
We got to do a little quality control here, Dorothy, to make sure this is a good week batch. Well, I certainly hope so. We got a lot out there. You tell me.
Okay. This is a great batch.
Really great. Fantastic batch.
I'm glad you like them.
Oh, thank you so much for having us out.
Thank you for coming.
Really, these are delicious. Dorothy, what is the number they call to order the pierogi?
747-3024.